Let us start with the quaternary Huffman coding procedure. So when I tell binary Huffman code, the codes which are used to design a code word is 0 and 1. If I tell ternary, we use the codes 0, 1 and 2. If I tell Huffman, we use the codes 0, 1, 2 and 3. So how to design a quaternary Huffman code for the symbols S1 to S7 with these probabilities? Okay. So first I arrange them in non-increasing probabilities, or what I tell is decreasing probabilities. This is what I do first. The probabilities 9 by 32, 9 by 32, 3 by 32, 3 by 32, 3 by 32, 3 by 32, and 2 by 32. So for the given problem, whatever is the given problem, I have arranged them in non-increasing probabilities. Now, I have to design a quaternary Huffman code. So, Huffman coding first procedure is, first step tells you that you have to arrange them in non-increasing probability. Second step tells the last R symbols have to be added. Last R symbols have to be added to form a composite symbol. This is what it tells. If R is 2, then it is binary. R is 3, I take last 3 symbols. If R is 4, I take last 4 symbols for addition. Now here it is quaternary. That means R is 4. Before that, if apart from binary, for ternary and for quaternary, we have to use this equation, where Q is the number of symbols given to you, which is 7. R is either it is binary, ternary or quaternary. Now it is 4. This is 4 minus 1, 3a. Now a will be equal to 1. If a is 1, if a is equal to integer, then no need to add a dummy symbol. No need to add a dummy symbol. If it is not equal to integer, if it is not equal to integer, then we add a dummy symbol with probability 0 is added to this group. This is what we have to check when we go for ternary and quaternary design of Huffman code, which is not applicable for binary codes where R is 2, because we can always get integer for R is 2. But if it is ternary and quaternary, if A is not equal to integer, then we have to add one more symbol whose probability is taken as 0, which is not required now because A we have got it as a integer. So let me start with the design of the Huffman code. First, I arrange as I had arranged them in non-increasing probabilities. Now, the last 4 symbols I have to take, because the last R symbols have to be added to form a composite in terms of for quaternary. So which are the last 4 symbols? These are the last 4 symbols. So rest I write as it is 9 by 32. One more 9 by 32 as it is. This 3 by 32 as it is. Now I get the addition 6, 9 and 11. I get 11 by 32. So I'm getting more than all these, correct? So what I have to do is I have to place it in, I should place it in the order of increasing probabilities. So I have to arrange this 11 by 32 here. It comes first. Rest all will come in the decreasing probabilities. This 9 by 32 came here. This 9 by 32 came here. This 3 by 32 will come here. And addition of these 4 forms composite symbols. Now no need to add furthermore, because we have left out with last R symbols. I have to stop the addition when I'm left out with last R symbols. If it was binary, then 2. Now it is quaternary, so 4 symbols. So we have to stop the addition here and assign the code words. The last column, assign the code words 0 and 1 if it is binary, 0, 1, 2 if it is quaternary, 0, 1, 2, 3 if it is ternary, 0, 1, 2, quaternary if it is 0, 1, 2, 3. Come back and fill the code table for your first column. 9 by 32 is what? 1. Another 9 by 32 is what? 2. 3 by 32 is what? 3. These 4 I can't fill as it is because they're giving rise to a composite symbol whose code is 0. So I should write this as 0, 0, 0, 1. This is what I did it in binary. 0, 2, ternary. 0, 3, quaternary. So this forms your design of Huffman code. If I want to write the complete code word for the given Huffman code, I write it as 1, 2, 3, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, and 0, 3. Then as it is, I can find the average length, entropy, as well as the efficiency.